22.4. Okay, more about main AC. Once again, you can see that this one is the extension part. It means that related to mathematics. Okay, now look at this. A, sinusoidal voltage. 同 cycle 有關係嘅 voltage. It means that this one should be changing with time t. Look at this. Main voltage varies as sine or cosine function. In mathematics, you can know that this function. V loss should be the peak value. In mathematics, for the sine function, the maximum value should be 1, positive 1, down to negative 1. So V naught will be the peak value related to time t. What's the omega? Omega similar to the angular velocity. Okay, should be related to this. 2 pi, do you remember in circular motion? Okay, in circular motion, you should remember this. Angular velocity should be the angular displacement 2 pi for one cycle. For one cycle should be 2 pi, and then for one cycle the time is t, so this one should be angular velocity. Angular velocity times time should be the angular displacement. It means that similar to the degree. Then we can get this. A higher omega, it means that the angular velocity is higher, shorter time to complete one cycle. In 1 second will be more cycle. Then when you look at the diagram, you can see that for the same time, we have more cycle. Okay, higher omega. How about this one? Instantaneous current. It means that at that time, what is the current? Because this one is AC, V is changing. Based on Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. R without any change, but V is changing. I is also changing. Then you can look at this formula. Current should be V naught over R. R will not be changed. Then you can see that this value will be changed. This one we will call it peak current. Also changing with the voltage. Voltage is sine, current is sine. Then the diagram will be like that. Once the voltage reaches the peak voltage, at the same time, the current should be the peak current because they are in phase. In wave, you should know that 同相, in phase. V and I change direction at the same time. How about the instantaneous power? It means that we know that the voltage at a certain time. We know that the current at a certain time. How about the power at that time? Just gonna multiply them together based on the power equation V squared over R or IV. Okay? Now look at this. For the V should be sine function. Multiply them together, we can see that sine square. And we can make this part peak power. Okay? And how about this power should be related to sine square omega t? What is it? Look at it, because we have this square. We know that for the sine function should be like that, positive and negative. But here we have the square, then everything will be positive. After plotting the graph, you can see that this. Now try to remember it. What happened? Within one cycle, we have two oscillation. Not only one, we have two. Okay, so look at this. Power is also sinusoidal, but once and for twice during a voltage cycle. 在一個週期裡面原本升降正一次負一次, 但如果你是 square function 之後, 它升跌呢, 就兩次的,這麼型的, okay? But how to interpret it? Just when you focus on mathematics, this. You can know that at that time, zero voltage, zero current, power should be zero. How about this? Zero voltage, zero current, zero power. How about last? Zero voltage, zero current, zero power. How about this? Maximum V, maximum I, we will have the maximum power. How about this? Negative V, but peak value. Negative I, but peak value. Negative, negative times it should be positive. Can you see it? Finally, you can see that go up, go up, go down, and then go up and go down again within one period. That's all. Okay? Example one, experiment one, like that. Okay, we will use this one, purpose, to find out the steady DC, deliver the same power as the sinusoidal voltage. It means that we want to find out the linkage between AC and DC. What should we do? Connect the signal generator,嗰啲 signal 嗰啲振盪器啦嚇，咁大家喺sound wave 嗰課有噶啦，出唔同嘅頻率嗰個機器咧，會做叫做 signal generator， and then increase the AC voltage until the light bulb grow， and then we give it light sensor to measure the brightness， find out the peak value from the CRO， see。And then replace the signal generator with the other AC to adjust the same brightness. So this one, what is the meaning? It means that we want to find out the voltage in AC and the voltage in AC to do the same job to make the light bulb grow with the same brightness. Okay, then look at this. Does the ratio depends on the peak value and the frequency? The answer is no. Depends on this. The ratio of it is more or less constant about square root 2 regardless the peak value or the frequency. Okay, it means that the average value should be the DC, the peak value will be the peak value, the relationship between them will be square root 2. We will explain it later. This one tells you that
we will find the effective value of a sinusoidal voltage. Connect a filament bulb to a signal generator. Increase the supplied voltage to the bulb glows. Measure the intensity of the bulb with a light sensor. Measure the peak voltage V log of the signal generator with a voltage sensor.
Remember that both of them have the same brightness.
Connect the bulb to a DC power supply and adjust the voltage.
The last one is the AC. Now using DC to do the same output.
When the reading of the light sensor is the same as before, record voltage VDC.
But you can find that the voltage.
Repeat the experiment with other amplitudes and frequencies of AC voltages. Find the ratio of V log to VDC.
To find out the ratio between them. The conclusion is the ratio must be square root 2. Okay? How to know that? Of course, mathematics. This one, average power, we want to use the mathematics to prove that Y is square root 2. Look at this, time average. We will use this symbol, 好似兩個雙箭嘴, okay, this bracket, to stand for time average of the power. P is V square over R, time average of V. Then what will happen? You can look at this diagram. If we draw the diagram, you can see that up and down twice within one cycle. We will like that. This one tells us that the power should be changing with time t. Now, in this diagram, we want to find out the average one. What should we do? 坐強負弱. It means that we will break this part into two, and then put this part here, put this part here. Finally, you can make the whole area into a rectangle. Okay, then this one we will say that FH power. Now here, to make the formula look like that's a steady DC, because in steady DC the power should be steady, it means the FH1. So what should you do? You should do it like this. Okay, you will have this star. It means that in order to find it out, this voltage, you should square root this part to make it like this, because originally for DC power will be VDC over R. We want to find out this part, so you should square root of it. Then this one, call it square root mean square. Okay, root mean square, what is the meaning of it? Root, it means that this part, root. Mean, it means that the average value of what? The value square, root mean square. A root mean square, you can have root mean square of the voltage or root mean square of the current. Now, try to look at it, how to find out root mean square. But before we find out, you should know that the definition of it is this. We know that for AC, at each time, the voltage is not the same. Okay, but we know that even the voltage are not the same, it will have the power consumption. We want to know that if we want to have the same power consumption, then what is the DC voltage you need to provide? We try to link up these two cases together. Then what should you do? You will try to make the DC voltage as a FH value. This FH value, we will say that root mean square. This one is also the method to find it out, root mean square. Go back to here, root mean square means that the equivalent DC, steady DC that gives the same FH power. 意思就是將 AC 做一些計數, 做到它出來的 power 和普通一個正常的燈膽 是光度一樣, 用的 power 一樣。 那我們嘗試呢, 就用 DC 裡面的資料, 例如它的 peak value 呢, 去找回, 它如果變成一個 steady 的 DC 的話, 應該多少? Okay? So, in general, root mean square of the voltage should be root mean square of current times R. Okay? And all the power equation, you can use it again. So, up to now, you just need to know that V, root mean square, and DC are the same. Okay, but at the back end, you should know that this one should be changing with time T. But steady DC should not be changed. Okay, 你可以當它義工同谷, 即是大家一模一樣的, 你可以當呢, 在AC裡面變成 root mean square, 就好像DC那樣, 所以DC所有計算的數學, 你都可以用得。 不過記住背後 AC是在變的。 So like this, for steady DC, V should be the same, current should be the same, power should be the same. But for this, on off DC, on and off, then what will happen? If we have the voltage, we have the power. If we haven't any voltage, we haven't any power. So in this case, in order to find out, you should calculate the total area, CO area, total area, and then add together, and then find out the FH value. You can see that the power should be half of original. How about this? If like that, this one is also AC. Okay, AC, we have this voltage V. Okay, then what should you do? Will be this, same power. Okay, because in this case, you can see that this one should be positive area, negative area, positive. But in AC, we have the square. Everything should be square. Okay? Because V is positive, I is positive. Power should be positive. For this, V is negative, current is also negative. Multiply them together is also positive. Your final answer should be this. the same. But how about sine wave? Sine function, what is it? You can see that the power should be the boron. Can you see it? The boron will be the instantaneous power of it. Then in order to find out the average value, the same, cut this part to here, cut this part to here. Then you can find that should be the midway, half of the power. How about this? Very difficult to find it out because this one is a triangular wave. Triangular wave will be like that. You can see that in order to make this part like that, this one is lower than half, will be one third. This part you need not to remember it. Okay, 你唔識計嘅 ，OK， 佢話俾你聽係咁就咁啦。 呢個呢，公開考試 MC 成日考嘅，小心啲。除咗呢個，除咗呢個，呢個好難計之外，唔計嘅。但係啲你要識，呢個你要識，呢個你要識。OK， OK， last part， part C， what mean square of the sinusoidal AC？ This one， what we want to prove it？ What is the relationship between root mean square and V log, the peak value? Then using the calculation, V is this, V square should be this, the bull one. Okay, a zero square is zero, but negative value square should be positive value. Then next case, V square oscillate symmetrically between 0 and V log square. Okay, then what will happen? The same. Here, cut it into two parts, fill in this one, fill in this one. Finally, you can get this rectangle. But pay attention, for the peak value, here should be V log square, and then half of it should be this. Okay, then in this diagram, you can see that the average V square should be V log square over 2. But remember that this one and this one are not true. 得唔得？嗱，記住， 呢一 part 咩嚟嘅咧？呢一 part 係將個平均嘅 V 嘅 square， 咁你望下呢度，平均嘅 V 呢個係正呢個負，平均嘅 V 係零，零嘅 square 點會係呢個咧？咁記住兩個唔同嘅，得唔得？ And then next part, you can see that for sinusoidal AC, power, okay, power should be this. This one is the average power. In order to find out the average, here, average V should be V log square over 2, okay? Then, V log square over 2, for this, V log square over 2. We can make it like this. V log over square root 2 square. Can you see it? Okay. Then using this part, you should know that the peak value over root 2 will be the root mean square value. Okay. Now this one explain it why. In Hong Kong, the main voltage should be 220. This one just only the average value. In this case, we will say that root mean square. The peak value will be 311. For the supply should be the sinusoidal signal. Okay, example 3. Here, heat production of AC. This one is not sinusoidal. This one is. Then what will happen? Look at this. For the square wave, Q should be 1,100 joule. This one, energy should be power T, PT. Okay, power should be V naught square over R. V naught you should find out from the graph should be a constant. Even we have the negative V naught. Okay. Then after calculation, you can find out this. But how about the sinusoidal? You just need to remember the relationship. Peak value over root 2 will be the root mean square. Then how about the heat production? Should be this power T. But remember that this power should be the FH power. Should be the FH power. The FH power should be FHV square over R. But what's the FHV? Should be the mean square of V. Then you can see that this. Finally, you can get this answer. Okay? Once again, I want to say that what's the mean square? Is the method. Is what mean square. For example, if we have the value, maybe 3. Maybe 3, maybe 2, maybe 1, negative 1, like that. And then maybe divided by 3. But why 3? Because you have 3 items. Okay? Then the root mean square will be do it like this. 直情是那些平均数来的，但每一个数字 square 了先make it positive, and then 除回你的几多个项，记得开放。咁喺 exercise 上边会有讲嘅，到时再讲。Okay, chapter 5. True false. Instantaneous power dissipated by a resistor in AC varies with time. Of course, yes, because V is changing, I is changing, power is changing. Part B. For AC of any form, root mean square is this. Yes, because this one follows the Ohm's law. For any form, any waveform will be peak value over root 2. This one is wrong. This one is only for sinusoidal signal only. In Hong Kong, means is this. What's the peak value? Just only remember it 311. But how to calculate it? Should be 220 times root 2, 311. Part B. Equivalent steady DC that give the same power, same FH power. Of course, 220, because 220 is the FH, this FH voltage. It means that you equivalent to a steady DC voltage. If appliance draw this current, what's the FH power? Exactly the same as DC. This, okay. 200. The current should be this. Pay attention. The question tell you the peak value. Peak value is 0.3. So you should try to find out the root mean square value of the current. Then you should divide by square root 2. Okay. Question number 3. Peak value given to you this. What is the FH1? Sinusoidal over root 2. But lots. Look at this again. Has a peak value is this. What is the FH current? Okay. Log root mean square current should be 0. But why? Because this diagram. In this one, mean current, peak 1, sinusoidal like this, the peak is 0.5. Pay attention, FH current, just going to FH it. Positive area, negative area, add them together, should be 0. Okay? So pay attention, FH value, just going to FH it, not root mean square. The question usually will ask you what's the root mean square value, then you should be 0.5 over root 2. Part B, another sinusoidal root mean square value will be this. Oh, okay, in this one, give you root mean square value. And then, which one gives the higher FH power? Okay, using the power equation, of course, should be I2. But why? Okay, because in this one, tell you root mean square value. It means that equivalent to DC. Equivalent to DC, this one should be 0.5A. Okay? Current in it should be higher in power. Okay? But how about the last one? This one, just the peak value is 0.5. How about the FH one? FH1 should be less than 0.58. Okay? Then pay attention on the root mean square and the peak value. You should find out the difference between them. Question number 4. Double the frequency of the AC. Peak voltage stays the same as before. Will the FH power increase? Of course not. Frequency does not affect the FH power. Okay, remember it. Okay? Okay, that's all.